Yeah, just good afternoon today. Today, 13th of January. So, I think screen is visible. This screen was PPT. We are basically pandas. I already covered a pandas, but here we are today. We are basically interested in Google Colab because Google TPU is there, Tensor Processing Unit is there, and you know, this is everything is there, neural network model, and everything can be done because. In CPU, basically whatever the difference between whatever you do at C programming, that is basically CPU based, but whenever you go for a GPU based, when the data is basically like image or audio, they are the like image based, and that is best for if you go for this GPU, and it is 10 times to, it depends on the application, it generally minimum 10 times to 20 times faster. Whenever if you go for tensor processing unit, tensor is, I have already told you, this is basically numerical array is the array contiguous place in the memory, and tensor is that you can work on it on GPU. It is a basically numeric array, but you can work on it as a in more than four dimensional and near minimum, it like you know the static is a single point, and whenever an array you can call it a array, and whenever the matrix is a two dimensional, three dimensional queue, that is basically called a tensor, and whenever three dimensional means x, y, z, the coordinates like anything in x, y, z, and if you have put in time, that is four dimensional. So, most of our real time data is fourth dimensional, or if you take the latitude, longitude, or if you take the all other spaces, maybe fifth dimensional. So, most of this data is fifth dimensional. It is best if you work on cloud TPU. So, these are available free in Google Colab. You please try it. This is the next, like CPU is an Intel like Xeon processor. It is available free for this. If you don't use the GPU, it is better not to make your runtime available GPU, otherwise it will always give a continuous alert that you are not using GPU, so release the GPU. So that is very like thing, whenever you are running a program in Colab, if you unnecessarily block GPU or TPU, if your work doesn't require GPU and TPU, it will give an alert like this. So, these all the things you can see in the program. So, let us see this in our program. Yes, we let the program, we will see it in the program. We basically today, because the pandas I have already covered, but I want to revisit you. This is the screen, I think everybody were getting it. Yes. So, now this is, I always prefer, I always, this is the version number I check. Exclamation mark, you can write down the any command. Import OS means you can run the OS level command, and if you want to see what are the files there, the exclamation mark ls minus l, you can see the this thing response, this is threading. So and you can always curious what is the main thread it is running on, so it is better, that is a print idea process of running main thread format OS get PID. If you, this is a call, and you can call OS because I have imported OS. So that is one of the reason I got the import OS. So anytime debugging, online debugging, it might help you to run some OS level command. If you work in Colab, so if you work in that OS level command, what is any dump and this thing. So that is the reason I put import OS there. And this is the, what is the PID number? PID means process identification number. So whenever the Unix program is running, there is always a PID, the first init process. These are the processes will come by come, and that is ultimately the user process will come. Every time you log in, one PID is allocated. Whenever you run any other task in anything, then you can get it a new PID number. The same these things you can get it through your Windows also. They just copied it. If you, the task manager, if you see, there are the what are the processes are running, but more transparent and more better if you see in Linux, then you can see the exact number. The numbers are in ascending order from, it will be always a, in each command will be 0 and 1, the PID, the whenever you boot up the machine, the first PID will be 0, 1 subsequently, and then the your current command, whatever you are running, and which is the command is running the allocated PID. If you want to kill that particular process, you do, then you can give a command kill KID double L minus N PID number. That's all. So that's great. So you can always see this. Just say run this command, then you can get it. What is happening there? Yeah, this is Python 3.69 version. ID of the process running is 61. Main thread, the main thread, that is the same, who are exposed to Java, they always know that is the main thread number. So this is the copy. In fact, Python or Java, even Java is much junior in age. Python is developed in 1990 and Java is 95-96. So basically you can say Java has copied the concept of Python. So they are contemporary. You remember that Java is statically typed and Python is dynamically typed. So dynamically typed means your type checking is done at right dynamic time, so that is slower, but both are strong entity types. So that Python and Java, it is true that you cannot put forcibly one convert to one thing to another, you have to convert with the typecast. Okay, that is a strong type entity. If you go for PHP or Perl, that is not weak entity type, so anything can be put to another. But after the Python came, the role of Perl or PHP, this programming language thrives because of web hosting. But Python takes up all the things single-handedly. They take up the web page design and the middle tier in the back end. Not that way, the front end. Front end JavaScript is better. So that's it. Okay. So this is a little bit discussion of this. So Python, you are getting version. There is NP. I always check the NP version. This is a PD version, Pandas version. So what is basically Pandas? Anyone please clarify what is the difference between NumPy and Pandas? The NumPy is a contiguous memory location. It is a array. Okay, is indexing 0, 1, 2, 3. It's the same type of. If it is integer 8 bit, it is all integer 8 bit. You cannot put a floating point number into it. So, but in real life, if you see, in whenever you take the data from various sites, say you, like today, now the hype is like this virus related data, vaccine, sorry, coronavirus too. That sometimes there various testing is done. So maybe RT-PCR techniques, maybe some of the antigen based testing, then there's and antibody based testing, they are giving various kinds of data there. Sometimes you get some test result that is not mentioned what is a RT-PCR or antigen or antibody. Even therefore, antigen and antibody, there are several types of testing methods are there. The RT-PCR testing also, maybe one or two methods are there, and their methodology is different. So sometimes you get a tables of data where no values is mentioned. Whichever. So, but you want to put this data for analysis. So, getting the data from the tables, it is not guaranteed that all the columns or all the rows should have the same data or not at all. There may be, might not be data. So, that is very difficult to handle in NumPy. NumPy, and you cannot mix match. So, say, is a NumPy is a same type of location, integer 64, so all are integer 64. You cannot put a floating point data into it. You cannot put a arbitrary value of data into it. So that is the flexibility of the Pandas. Pandas is consists of Pandas series, that is one column, and Pandas series is basically a dictionary. It can be dictionary, it can be list, and all these things. You can think it's better as a dictionary, that is a Pandas series. A lot of Pandas series together, it is called Pandas data frame. And only one restriction is there, the all the column length is equal. Okay, that's all. No other thing. So Pandas series is a singular column. And also there is no restriction, not has to be same data type. That is a great thing other than NumPy, that is a column name can be changed. So definitely you can, it is not a contiguous memory location, but it is Pandas data structure. So that data frame, that is data series, which is a dictionary. So dictionaries can be added column wise. So that's a great this thing. So anything you have a doubt, that is a Panda data series. So let's get it. So this is a Panda data series. Yes, and how can I call? Because I already imported pandas. So this import pandas. So I already know what is the panda version. So this is if I check it. Yeah. So this is the see here data is one and is not a number. I put a data floating point. Yeah. So all these things are that actually this is a floating point of data. Everything can be possible. So here I put in another data series. Here I have a floating point number. This is string. This is not a number. This is a date time. Another great thing is that is the Panda data frame. You can put a date time object. So that is you cannot get it in NumPy, and you can put it Boolean value also. I have tried it Boolean value. So here you if you run it, you see is a class pandas code series, and it is all the same. This I have not started in data frame. It is a series basically. Series can be a dictionary, can be list, can be NumPy array. All these things is possible. Any different types is possible. And most interesting is that is a date time, which is very essential whenever you come for a time series data. You want to take the data for the say how much heat wave is generated for the this is called one of the hottest year. 2020 is on the hottest year. So you have to data for last 400 years meteorological data you can get it. So you did lot of series data where date and time has been there. So that's it. So now you can construct a data frame from a dictionary also. So I have created a dictionary here. You know the famous dictionary signal is then column. So dictionary and data frame and data frame you put it dictionary name is here. And if you run it, so these are two dictionary. One is column one and this is column two. This is one dictionary column one and this is the index. Yeah. So index is also this is whenever you put in a data frame, you can have a either 0, 1 or you can put other type of index also. That is a great advantage. So this is a dictionary and this thing. And you can see the data types by this command df, this is data frame dot data types, integer 64. You can say no, I want it to int 8. So that you can give a command like data frame, pd data frame, data dictionary, the d type np integer. So you have to default is integer 64, but you can tell it. So it is this feature is mostly like of NumPy also. NumPy this flexibility is there. So if you run this, yeah, this if you run this, then if you see this column 1 int 8, that's great. So let's get constant data frame and NumPy d array. So here is another command. So here you can see the np array. I am putting some array. Instead, earlier I have given example putting columns, but I can put it array also. That is flexibility. So basically, these are the arrays. Data frame. Yeah, and this now these are the columns. Okay, so this 1, 2, 3 is a row wise. So but your series is column wise. Always you see the pandas series is column wise and total. This thing is a data frame and only restriction is all the columns should be of equal length. Okay, so that's it. You can see this examples. Okay, break. Say this is another great thing. Whenever you have a period, I have already told you data range period like this. You have a type dates. So this is you have a dates up there. So that is you cannot get it in NumPy. Okay, you can get it. That is a great thing, and you can also see it by indexing is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, x. Remember, 0 always indexing starts at 0. The print data 0, it is this series, this particular. Otherwise, you have the 4. If you see the full, if you give the all are there, like this is the all data. Okay, so I am getting the data 0, that is this one. Okay, so this is great. Yeah. So that is true. Let's like here I share with you is a data frame. Here I have a three guy Bob, Jane, Tim. One can be girl also. So don't have like this. The ages is like 20, 30. So three columns are there. This is a column one. This is series one, I can say, and this is a series two, and this is a pet. So these are all make a data frame on this. Let's do it. Yeah, and then we get it. This is the your values. Yeah, this is we have. I always check what is the data type. Is it, you say is a pandas score frame data frame. It is better to check. It will be help you for debugging. And this is the index. And these are the values. Say this is a name, age, weight. And you can also sort on it on name, age, weight. That is great. And 0, 1, 2. These are the all these things. So if you have, and you can see the indirectly by df.name, the both the commands can do. You can get the name or you give this command. Both the command gives you. This is age. This is, see, you get this weight. Yeah, and you can see the this sorting can be done. If you just check it, the news. I'm going to the actual examples where it is there. Yeah, introduction to pandas is a basic, and if you see the import, just command run anyway. Then this is the command running it here. This is a Bob age. This is three columns, and these are the I've already shown it to you. DF columns and index. Index they are always showing. And these I have already shown it to you, df name that way, it's a pet. I actually running all these commands, so I am coming to this, yeah, this is location 0, Bob, all details are Bob, and then you can have sort values. So, you can put it the value sorting by pet in place true, all these things. Yeah, see here after sorting the it was comfortable because the my pet is the my sorting and it should be in place and ascending. So which one pet? The bird comes before cat and C comes before dog. So it gives team first because it's sorted on bird. So you can, this is the great example. This is sort and your sorting criteria on pet in place. So it will be, you cannot, it will be in place sorting. I think in data structure class you know what is in place sorting. In place sorting, you are not moving it, you are just indexing it. You are not moving the actual movements of data. You index in another file, there you say this one number one right now. So in place means true and ascending true. So sort means bird will come first, then cat, then dog. So this is great. I think. Yeah. So these are the examples, like you can have cells and you can see the data at any time. So that's it today. These are the examples will be given to you. I just quickly go some whatever we have already done. So because why you are going for pandas, please pandas is for basic because with Python without NumPy doesn't mean anything. It's just a simple one day job. So Python and one day job. Then NumPy, when the NumPy gives Python, it's actually core values. The Python is comparable with sometimes Java and C because NumPy is mainly written in, you know, the C++ and it's run really faster. So it definitely not as fast as C, but it can handle much quicker problem. But NumPy has some also limitation because NumPy means contiguous memory location and on the same type, maybe integer or float point. That is the reason pandas come. Pandas is basically built on NumPy and the core Python. So you can have the columns of anything. Columns can be dictionary, can be list, can be arrays, can be NumPy arrays, but you can take it a column is basically a dictionary. So the columns has to be joined together. Then it's called data frame. Only restriction is all columns should not be here. One column may be 10 entries, and another column may be 8 entries. Is not possible. So that is one thing. It is still they are not there in Python. Maybe one day another library might come which can handle the various zigzag way of table. But still now the pandas are all columns are same. Row type can be various type. So all these things, this pandas is there. Then we can SciPy. SciPy is more advanced tabulations, tabulation data, like if I want to get the various linear algebra solution, like you can get roots of polynomial and you can get eigenvectors and all these things, all kinds of linear algebra calculation can be done on SciPy. These basically help you. The another the plotting is Matplotlib. I have already given one lecture. I wish to give Matplotlib. We can make plot the data on various your computer, your laptop, your mobile phone. Then it is called Seaborn. Seaborn is another graphical software. So all these things makes you ready for the machine learning. The machine learning, that is means till now we have put data and program. Now in machine learning we have lots of output data, like lot of say virus out data and all these things. So you can have to see how to get the program identification program. That is great. For all these things we are learning, and there we know that lots of data is you have to curve fitting all these things. It is called regression. There is difference between regression and classification. Regression is a continuous type and it is two dimensional. It can be in NumPy array, it can be multi dimensional. So there you need this kind of utilities, NumPy, pandas and the data. This thing I think today I'm expecting everybody should want, definitely no expecting you everyone. Now you please can question, please, any questions whatever, and the quiz will be on basic Python, NumPy and one or two comments maybe on SciPy and even the TensorFlow. I have given you what is Tensor and all the basic comments of TensorFlow. You know what is TensorFlow and PyTorch, that is NumPy can be contiguous memory location, and whenever you put this NumPy onto this GPU or TPU, you need Tensor. That is the difference between TensorFlow or PyTorch. These are basically can handle Tensor. Difference between Tensor and NumPy is NumPy you have to handle it on CPU. The NumPy generally cannot work on GPU or TPU. The GPU and TPU you have to put in a Tensor. What is Tensor? Tensor is a two dimension, and we call it a matrix. Whenever it's three dimension, we call it a tensor. So matrix is also two dimensional tensor, and most of the data and real time video and audio are the tensor that can be only worked with the GPU and TPU. And there we have a lot of algorithms we had already done. Some of you have already done. So these are the areas, machine learning. The Python is supreme. Right now the Python is the number one, and R is there. Both are open source. So that is a main people are learning, the deep learning, and then comes the deep learning. What is the difference between machine learning and deep learning? They are almost same. The deep learning, program can learn the data. So many data are already available, so that you can learn. The program is actually writing itself, the program. Any question on, please? Yeah, tell me.
Sir, what is reinforcement learning?
Yeah, good question. Anyone can try? So, good question. Reinforcement learning, yeah. Reinforcement learning is basically your, clustering versus reinforcement learning is you are taking some decisions, but immediately that decision is not whether it is a success or failure, it is not available. Maybe after 10, 20 steps or maybe 50 steps, you are getting the result. What is required? Whenever see in Chandrayaan, our launch vehicle, whenever it probably 1 year back, whenever it gets to the orbit, and whenever it's just before landing, maybe before 1 minute, earlier all these vehicle, Chandrayaan vehicle can be controlled by the telemetry from this place, because you have lots of data available at your ISRO station at Bangalore. So you can give commands so that you can it can get first get out of the orbit of the our escape velocity, takes out the Earth and then into moon, circling around moon. Then when the it comes closer and goes closer, you have to make the rocket fires to make it slow it down, because whenever you go to the moon, again its gravitation, moon's gravitation is working, it will be more faster. So you have to make rocket in the reverse direction, make it slower. Then you have to put the vehicle down into the moon surface, and then you cannot command from your Earth. So you need a certain intelligent things at your both the places, the satellite which is orbiting around the moon and the vehicle which is coming down on moon landing, there's some reinforcement learning is there. It's an intelligent software which can learn by itself without being any learned from any place. Okay, are you getting my point? That is called reinforcement learning. That is one of the latest topic in there. What is basically earlier it was supervised learning. Lots of data are there. You put it to a software, then unknown data can be matched. That is supervised learning. One positive point of supervised learning is you need a simple hardware and all these things it can do. And lot of work has already done for the last 20-30 years. And what is, and you get the regression in whenever you put to a continuous value, that is regression. And whenever you put the data to classify, because whether which is a tumor, most tumor type 4 is the most critical tumor, tumor 1 is maybe benign tumor. So that is a classification. And then comes the, this is called supervised, unsupervised. The classification name is different, it is called clustering. So it will be without any supervision, they all already learned where the tumor can be, might be and all this. That is unsupervised, that is called clustering. And between reinforcement and unsupervised is semi-supervised learning. This is one of the topic areas are there. And another is reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning is another subtype, so that the data is actually learning from itself by intelligent this thing. So it is basically in the more in the unsupervised learning. It is not supervised learning at all. It is unsupervised learning. But unsupervised learning means if you are, you can quickly get the result. It is more critical, more critical than unsupervised learning. More extreme side of unsupervised learning, that is the reinforcement learning. It is generally used for any launch vehicle or right now you say both Jeff Bezos or Elon Musk are putting satellite, putting vehicle into the outer station and re-entry to the re-entry to the Earth. They are all using this this reinforcement learning. So this is the age the reinforcement learning would come. I think I have answered you. If anything is clear.